Today's Google Doodle commemorates the birth date of Edith Cavell, a British nurse who was executed by firing squad during World War I for helping Allied soldiers to escape occupied Belgium. This article celebrating her life and legacy was originally published on the 12th of October 2015. In the succession of sombre anniversaries that fell during the long centenary of the First World War, few were as poignant as the 100th anniversary of Edith Cavell's execution by the Germans in 2015. In a war when the great majority of the horrors occurred on the battlefield, unlike the one that followed in 1939-45, the execution of a British nurse by firing squad was one of the most shocking, barbaric events of the conflict. And yet, out of the sense of outrage that has resonated down the years ever since, there emerged one of the most powerful and significant foundation stones for the profession of nursing, one that no other individual other than perhaps Florence Nightingale has matched. At a time when nursing is constantly challenged and scrutinized, it is worth reflecting on the personal qualities that Edith Cavell instilled in this caring profession. Her work as a nurse was driven by a combination of her Christian upbringing as the daughter of a clergyman and a strong altruism that she expressed to her cousin when she was 30. "Someday, somehow, I am going to do something useful. I don't know what it will be. I only know that it will be something for people." Once she had embarked on her career as a nurse, she demonstrated from the outset a clear understanding that good intentions were not sufficient to excel in her vocation. Determination, diligence and discipline drove her throughout her training at the London Hospital and established the firm belief that high standards, not superficial kindness, was the key to good nursing. Humanity and an unqualified concern for her fellow men were instinctive, and so she was free to concentrate on showing patients the competence and efficiency so vital to their reassurance. "I have recently been reminded of the significance of these principles because my elderly mother died in early September, having spent her last weeks in different hospitals. In the first, some nurses' idea of care was to speak to her as if she was a small child with learning difficulties, convinced that care was about regular but meaningless communication. Quite different was the ward in the second hospital where she spent her last 2 days, with a sister in charge who embodied the priorities handed down by Edith Cavell. Militarily efficient and competent, she was at the same time deeply and appropriately compassionate. Edith Cavell was executed for helping wounded British soldiers to recover, then escape back to Britain via neutral Holland. She had worked as a nursing matron in Belgium since 1907, when she became head of a clinic in Brussels and established a training school for nurses. At the outbreak of war, she immediately set about ensuring that her nursing facilities were available to all soldiers, as her biographer Diana Sue Hammy wrote. She told her nurses that they must not take sides in the conflict. Their work was for humanity. Any wounded man must be medically treated. Each was equal at the point of need. But it was not long before her assistance to British soldiers seeking to escape was noticed by the occupying Germans, and she was entrapped by a spy masquerading as a wounded officer. German revenge was swift. After being found guilty of treason by a military tribunal, she spent 10 weeks in solitary confinement, and then, at 7 a.m. on the morning of October 12, 1915, she was led out and shot. She was 49 years old. The execution swiftly came to be acknowledged as one of the most infamous events of the war. It drove strong anti-German feeling in Britain and a fierce will to win the war. Cavell's face was used on recruitment posters. It also inspired determination to celebrate her achievements, especially her championing of nurses. The Daily Telegraph launched a national appeal for funds in her memory that raised £12,500, more than £500,000 today. In 1917, Cavell Nurses Trust was set up to use the funds to support nurses in need, and the trust has continued to do this ever since. The National Garden Scheme was established 12 years after Edith Cavell's execution to raise funds for district nurses. In its first year, 1927, 600 gardens raised £8,000. Today more than 3,500 gardens raise more than £3 million annually for donations to a group of nursing and caring charities. In the year that marked the centenary of Edith Cavell's execution, it was agreed that the NGS should give £50,000 to Cavell Nurses Trust. There could be no better reminder of the true qualities of nursing and of the constant need for the profession to be nurtured and supported.